Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and learn. Your tutor is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. In today's lesson, we are in Form 1, Lesson 22. And the topic is farm tools and equipment. The subtopic is masonry tools and equipment. Remember, we are on the fifth tool. Or on the fifth classification of farm tools and equipment. We started in the previous lesson, we have dealt with the garden tools and equipment being the first category. Then the second one, we covered the livestock production tools and equipment. In the third category, we dealt with the workshop tools and equipment, and in the fourth category we covered the metalwork tools and equipment. And in today's lesson, we are on the subtopic of masonry tools and equipment. On to the lesson objectives. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to, number one, explain the various uses of masonry tools and equipment. The second objective is to state the various ways of maintaining the masonry tools and equipment. We have various examples of masonry tools and equipment. The tools which are normally used by the masons in their course of work. The first one, we have the mason's trowel. A mason trowel, the function of a mason trowel is to place a mortar between the building stone. They normally use the mason's trowel to put a mortar in between the building stones or blocks. Then we have this, the wood float. The wood float is used when it comes to plastering, when you are plastering a certain wall or a certain walls of a house or a wall of a fence, you normally use a wood float. Then this the steel float is the one which is used whenever you are applying the floor or whenever you are applying the screed on the wall, because it is very soft. Then we have the plumb bob. A plumb bob, you can see there is a mason there. Using a plumb bob to check for the verticalness of a particular wall, and therefore a plumb bob is normally used to take for the verticalness of a certain wall. Then we have the mason square. It is also used to take to make sure that a given surface is very vertical. It is very vertical. It is used to measure the angle 90 degrees. Then we have the spirit level, is the one which is normally used to measure for the horizontal of the level, whether the level is horizontal or, and also it can be used to check for the verticalness of a given surface. Then we have a wheelbarrow. Yes, a wheelbarrow is used when it comes to measuring of the ballast and also the measuring of the sand. And therefore, if you want to make a concrete, you have to measure the ballast, and also you measure the sand when it comes to preparation of the the concrete. Then we have the spade, is the one which is normally used to scoop the sand and also the ballast whenever you are doing construction work. Then we have a mason's hammer. A mason's hammer is the one which is used to strike the head of a cold chisel whenever a mason is shaping the stones or removing the unneeded part of a stone during construction work. Then we have the reasons for maintaining. Why do we maintain? For example, if you have a tool like a wheelbarrow, Why should we maintain it? You should apply grease in the moving part, for example, in the wheel, to make sure that you reduce the friction and therefore facilitating easy movement and therefore increasing the efficiency. And also the reasons as to why the tools should be maintained is to reduce the cost of replacement. The second one is to make the tool durable. If you maintain the tools, it means that the durability of the tool also increases. Number three, we have to avoid the tool from injuring the user. And finally, to increase the efficiency, as I have already discussed. We have come to the end of today's lesson, and I will give you the following assignment. The question number one, list any four types of masonry tools and equipment. And number two, state any three reasons for caring and maintenance of masonry tools and equipment. For reference, you can refer from Secondary Agriculture Student Book 1, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, you can reach us at Elim TV using the following addresses. The first one is SMS using the number which is well displayed for you. And the second one is YouTube at Elim TV. The third one at Facebook platform at Elim TV. And also you can use the Twitter at @ElimTV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson. Bye-bye.